today we are going to study the third experiment, which I will upload quite later on YouTube, and that is from the major experiment from the ecology, and that is how to determine the pH of different soil samples with the help of either pH paper or pH meter. So students, we are having a pH paper along with, so you can see here, so this is the pH paper. Okay, that pH paper is having different color grades ranging from 0 to 14. So every one of you know that the 7 is called as neutral pH. However, if a reading comes from 0 to 7, then it considered as acidic, and if it beyond the 7 onward up to 14, then it is called as basic. Okay, so what we need for this experiment, so look at here, we required a 3 soil sample for which we have to do the analysis, sample A, B and sample C. Then we required a water, so 50 ml of water we need to add in every beaker. So I have taken up 150 ml of water, which I will later on add equally on the remaining 3 beaker. Then we need a pH paper. Okay, so look at here, the pH papers are labeled as A, then it's a second one is a, you can see here, the second one is a B, A, B, and the third one is a C. Okay, so this is the litmus, this is the pH paper which we will use according to the sample, because soil samples are also given a mark as a A, then B and sample C. Okay, so now this is the sample correct, how to collect the soil sample in order to serve soil analysis. So every one of you know that while collecting the sample for the pH of soil, so we have to first of all dig a soil up to a 5 to 6 feet, and then we have to collect the sample so that it will give the exact value of a pH of that soil. Okay, so these, and apart from that, the site of selection of a soil, that must be apart from each other, otherwise what will happen, if we keep the site of collection very close to one another, then we will get the same type of result. Okay, so in order to analyze the different types of soils according to the geographical region, the distance must larger be the distance, more will be the variance which we'll encounter regarding with the pH value of a different soil sample. Okay, so in the same way, I have collected the 3 soil samples A, B and C. In the same way, I have prepared a 3 litmus paper, 3 pH paper. Now what we have to do, we have to measure each soil sample and take it in a 5 gram with the help of weighing balance. So I will measure each sample take it into a 5 gram quantity, and then I have to add this 5 gram of soil sample. Suppose this is the A soil sample, so I will take 50 ml of tap water in a beaker A. So look at here, so 50 ml of beaker is already having a mark, so it is easy for me to add 50 ml of water. Okay, so this is the 50 ml of water in beaker A. Then in the same way, we have to add a 50 ml of water, tap water, in the beaker C, and the remaining water, as I have taken 150 ml, so of course beaker B is having a remaining 50 ml. Okay, so I have taken the 50 ml of water in each beaker, and now what we have to do, we have to measure that soil up to a 5 gram, and then each soil, suppose sample A soil, we have to add 5 gram into A beaker, then sample B 5 gram soil we have to add in a sample B beaker, and sample C 5 gram of soil we have to add in a 50 ml of water taken in a C beaker. Okay, so let's measure the soil up to 5 gram, and then we will add this 5 gram in a respective tap water label as a beaker A, B, C respectively. Okay, and once we add the soil, we have to stir it properly so that it will form a homogeneous mixture. Okay, so just wait for a minute so that we can weighing the soil and add it properly into a corresponding beaker. Acidic, neutral and basic. Okay, so what is meant by acidic pH? So acidic pH of water or soil is determined on the basis of hydrogen ion concentration. Okay, so you can see here in this trick a value 1 to approximate up to the 7 that indicate acidic pH. Okay, so acidic pH means it is responsible due to the hydrogen ion concentration. A value 1 indicates the highest pH. So as we run down, the value become decreases to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it means that the pH is also decreases. So the decrease in pH directly corresponds to decrease in hydrogen ion concentration. And when it comes to 7, 7 is the value which is called as neutral. Means the solution is neither acidic neither basic, or we can say that it is having an equal concentration of hydrogen ion as well as the same concentration of OH ion. So a value close to 7 always indicate, or exact 7 always indicate a neutral pH. Now when we move onward from 7 to 14, it indicate the basicness of water or basicity of a soil sample. Okay, so basicity is determined on the basis of OH ion, hydroxyl ion concentration. So from the neutral value 7 to 14, as we are moving from 7 onward, the basicity is increases due to the increase in the hydrogen ion, increase in the hydroxyl ion concentration OH ion, and decrease in the hydrogen ion concentration. So the value 8 indicate a slightly basic solution, and as we are moving onward 9, 10, 11, the basicity increases and its maximum value is at 14. So at 14, the OH concentration is at its maximum concentration. However, hydrogen ion is at its lower concentration. Okay, so this is very simple. So OH determine the basicity of the solution. However, hydrogen ions determine the acidity of the solution, and its equal amount of hydrogen ion and OH ion always results into a neutrality of the solution. Okay, so with this we will move for. Okay, student. Let's see. So A, B and C, these are the basic soil sample collected. However, later on I have measured the 5 gram of each soil sample from that contained. So you can see here from A sample its 5 gram is measured here. From a B sample, you can see here from a B sample its 5 gram is measured here, and from a C sample its 5 gram is measured here. Okay, so in this way, now what you have to do, you have to just add this 5 gram in a respective label beaker. Okay, each beaker is having equal quantity of 50 ml of distilled water. Okay, now one by one we will add this soil in a respective beaker. So this is the beaker A. So we have so this is having a 50 ml of distilled water, and we will add a 5 gram of soil within it. Okay, so in this way, so once you add this soil, just shake it properly so that it will help to dissolve the soil as early as possible. Okay, in the same way repeat the procedure for sample B and sample C. This is the beaker label as a B, and in this we will add a second soil sample label as soil sample B. Okay, and then here also we have to stir it properly. Okay, the second one, B, this is the first one. In the same way we have to repeat the procedure for the C. So C soil sample, we will add in a C beaker having a 50 ml of distilled water. So once we add it, we have to mix it properly so that it will form a homogeneous mixture. Okay, so in this way, this is sample C, this is sample B, okay, and now we are having a sample A also. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to now keep this soil sample to settle down so that whatever the soil contents which are floating or which are moving in the suspended form, they will settle down. So for that we have to wait for 15 minutes, and once the content settle down, we have to dip the Wattman filter paper and measure the pH content. Okay, so just wait for 15 minutes so that the soil content becomes settled down, and we will test the pH paper with the help of Supernal. Sample with the help of Supernal. Okay, so look at here, this is the strip label as A. Okay, and I will dip it in a Supernal up to the 2/3 of the strip and let it allow for dry to keep in a slanting position. Okay, then this is the strip B, and we have to dip that strip B in a second solution up to its 2/3, and again the same, we have to also settle down by keeping it in a slanting position, and then strip C, that is the pH paper level as a C, we will dip it up to the 2/3 of the solution, soil sample C, and then it will also, this will also, we will keep in a slanting position, so in order to allow them dry. So once the strip become dry, they will appear a particular color, and that color we have to match with the different color ranks which are given on this pH paper. So we have to match what color is matching with the that strip color, and according to that the values are given, that will be the pH of a respective sample. So let it allow to dry for 5 to 10 minutes, and then we will again come here to check what this soil sample is having their exact pH. Okay, so wait for 10 minutes and then again we will check it for the student. So look at here, this is the A, B and the C strip, and this is our pH paper. Okay, so let's see, this is the pH paper. So now we have to match the color, which one is more perfectly match. Okay, so look at here, so as far as A sample is concerned, it will somewhat pale orange in color, so which will range up to 3 to 5, it is in between 3 to 5, so it means that if we take a middle value, so it comes close to 4, so it means that the first sample of the soil is acidic in nature. So as the pH value comes 4. Okay, so if we compare with the second soil sample, so second soil sample is having a pH, a color which is a pale greenish, so it is somewhat again more pale greenish, so it is very close to a neutral, but not exactly neutral. It comes to 6.2 or 6.3 because it is in the range of between 6 to 7 value. Okay, if we come for the C sample, so C sample is having a somewhat greenish color, though it is a light green, but it is a greenish in color. It means it always comes close to the 8 or below 8. Okay, so if the value is comes below 7 or close to 8 or a little bit below to 8, then it is of course basic in nature. Okay, so in this way, on the basis of the color of this Wattman of this pH paper, you can clearly look at here, you can clearly gauge the pH of a soil sample. Though the pH is not the exact one, it is but more accurate, and we will make a comment regarding with the its close value of the pH, whether it is what in the range. Okay, so this is the simple experiment, and with the help of this you can take a pH of any soil sample, and according to what is the use of this experiment, so accordingly that you can check the soil of a particular farm, and accordingly you can crop a plants, you can take a yield, so that it will benefit it to that particular texture of a soil, that particular pH of a soil is helpful for the yield of a particular crop plants. Okay, so this is the ultimate aim. Okay, so thank you again.